There's been a lot of farm work happening around here since the weather turned nice, which means we're outside as much as we can possibly manage to be. The problem is that when we're outside, we come back in so hungry. Carbs won't do. You need sustenance. So I want to share with you one of my very favorite, you could make it when you're hungry or you can make it ahead, whichever. But this is one of our go-tos. It's one we love to make and one we love to eat. And it's even made better by Porter Road.
I know a lot of you who enjoy our channel aren't farming your own animals for meat. So what happens then when you want high quality pasture raised roasts and whole chickens, dry aged steaks, beautifully cured hams, bacon, and ground sausage? This is why I am so grateful to introduce you to Porter Road. Even here where we produce a lot of our own meat, we are still in need of certain cuts to fill holes in the freezer or things that we just have a hankering for and that we don't raise ourselves. Simply put, Porter Road checks all of my quality standards with zero compromises. What founders Chris and James are doing here, from the animal husbandry standards, which I care a lot about, to their food standards, they are absolutely top of the line. I genuinely cannot recommend their meat products highly enough to you. Click the link below the video to get 15% off your first order with Porter Road and stock up on all those beautiful meats.
You want to come help me? Can I bribe you with a glass of wine to come help me peel these eggs?
All right.
So this is a really simple, by the way, if you can hear George in the background, she's practicing for her piano adjudications. So she's going to carry on. All you need to have is the components. And every time I feel like I get behind the ball when it comes to food, I realize it's because I haven't stocked up on what I need. Now, some of that's just eating through the larder, but some of it's actually buying pieces to bring into the kitchen so that we have what we need, like really high quality sausages and bacon, which we get from Porter Road. But you can just peel them.
That's what I'm doing.
You're peeling right. Eggs.
What are we even making?
We're making Scotch eggs. So full of fat, full of protein, full of flavor. I mean, it's just a powerhouse of calories, which is what you need, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you're laboring.
Yeah.
Usually when I come in, I just need meat, like deep sustenance.
Need some good protein.
Need solid protein.
Yeah. We've been making Scotch eggs for a while now, like a long time.
Yeah, I was 21 when I had my first Scotch egg when I was visiting you in Bellingham.
That's right.
And I didn't know what it was. Jeremy ordered it. My brother-in-law ordered it off the menu. I had no idea what it was. And it came and I was like, what is this little ball of the gods? Just amazing. I don't know what's going on back there. All right, so you need a few components. You need hard-boiled eggs. Now, you'll also see this done with soft-boiled eggs. That's a bit more precious, not as conducive to farm work, because I like to eat it on the go.
Well, and I think, the story I'm familiar with Scotch eggs, is that they were sort of like a on-the-go food for...
Right.
Farmers in the field, or like, you know, shepherds out all day, and you could kind of make these Scotch eggs, put them in your pocket, your jacket pocket,
yeah,
and like eat on them throughout the day.
I mean,
I don't know how much truth there is to that, but a story like that's got to be true.
It's got to be true. Yeah. So the family story that I grew up with, which was like, people doing that with lefse, where they'd wrap meat inside their lefse, put it into their little pocket, and then they'd have it at lunchtime. So you need, I guess I'll need one more bowl.
What you making?
Scotch eggs.
If you wash your hands, you can help me in a sec. All right, so all you need is the component. We've got really beautiful eggs from our chickens. Somebody just asked me in the cooking community, what do I do with all these eggs? Because when the light starts to come back, the chickens start to lay a lot more. So some hard-boiled eggs. The traditional coating on the outside of a Scotch egg is breadcrumbs, but I like panko. I think it has a better texture.
Mm-hmm. I like panko too.
So yeah.
You could also roll it in oats and stuff.
So you just need your components. We've got some hard-boiled eggs here. The chickens have started laying a lot again. So we've got a lot of eggs. We've got panko. Traditionally, it's breadcrumbs or oats on the outside. I love panko. It has a good texture. And then a few additional eggs. because that's going to help our panko to stick on the outside. But probably the most important component is the meat that you use that wraps around the egg. So if you've never had a Scotch egg before, it's an egg that's peeled. You wrap the whole thing in a sausage, then you roll it in your egg, roll it in your breadcrumb, and you fry it. And I know that sounds like a lot, but it's meant to be a lot. It's meant to be like a one and done. You eat it, you've got enough calories to last you for a good portion of the day, which is exactly why we eat them. When you're out gardening, you get so tired. But there's something really exciting that I want to share with you, because I get asked this a lot, especially by cooking community members, is where do you get your tallow? Where do you get your lard? I've said this many times before that I'm not afraid of frying food. Everybody loves fry food. That's why we do it. But it really does matter if you're looking at it from a nutritional standpoint, what you fry your foods in. Not all fats are created equal. And so for a long time, I've been an advocate for frying your foods in tallow or lard, which are both very traditional, very good for you fats. Good for you. Imagine that. And Porter Road just announced their new line of tallow and lard. So I'm very excited about this, because this, it comes in this beautiful little container, easy to stock up, keep in your fridge, always keep. I have a full box in my walk-in cooler just of tallow, because I love it so much. So this is what we're gonna be frying our eggs in. This is what we're gonna be using. And remember, not even all tallow is created equal. You wanna source it from really healthy animals. It is impossible in the town where I live, maybe you have better luck than me, to find a super high quality pork product. High quality bacon from pigs that are raised in a way that I can stand behind, the way that I would be proud of. They're impossible to find here unless you raise your own pigs. Drives me crazy, because that means the only option is to raise the pigs myself, which I don't want to do in this season of my life. So it's one of the reasons I'm super grateful for companies like Porter Road that are really doing it right. And my freezer is always stocked with those pork products because I love to eat them. But that doesn't mean I want to put the work in of raising and butchering my own pig again right now. So I'm going to be making my Scotch eggs with two of their different products today, a loose sage sausage and my very favorite, which is loose chorizo. So they also offer this in links, but we want the loose because we want to form it around our egg. This way people can pick their flavor a little bit. So this is what I'm talking about. When you look at the ingredients of this, pork, ice, which just they use to grind the pork, spices, salt, dehydrated garlic. That is what I like to see in my pork products. And then you dig a little deeper into how the animals were raised, how they were, what they were fed, how they were butchered, and it all lines up. It lines up exactly with what I like. All right, we've got chorizo, we've got sage sausage. By the way, you can make these ahead, stick them in the refrigerator and just warm them up when you want to eat them. So it's great to do a big batch of them just like this. Okay, the process is simple and fun. Just grab a piece of the sausage and I'm pressing it thin in my hand, grabbing it. Did you peel this one?
Yes.
Placing it in and then gently forming the sausage around the egg. And you gotta be patient, move it around. Close it all together and it'll start to form.
Can I try one?
Can you try one?
Yes.
Yeah, just a second, okay. All right, so long as we've got it all covered and it's even, that's exactly what we want. So once it's coated, we go into our egg. We go into our crunchy, gorgeous panko here.
What's panko?
Panko is a Japanese breadcrumb. Look at that. That's gonna be so good. Okay, line them up and keep going.
Can I try one?
All right, I'm gonna make a chorizo one though. Can you do it? Let's see. Okay, so first thing, Willie, grab it in your hand. Mm-hmm. Give you a little bit more. Okay, now flatten it out. Press it down. Yeah, keep flattening it more. Ooh, this is a big egg.
I don't have big hands.
Oh, I love chorizo.
It smells really good.
You know what I used to think chorizo was?
What's that?
I used to think that it was only chorizo if it was made with the salivary glands of the pig.
Hmm.
I feel like I read that somewhere. Might have even said it in the early days of the blog. But it's really just a paprika spiced sausage. Mm-hmm. That's all it is. It's a certain flavoring. Oh, that's perfect, buddy. Okay, here, I'll do it in the egg. You do that one in the panko, okay? Okay, you do this one, buddy. This one now. Really press messy. Them in there. It is messy, especially when two people are in the bowl at the same time. Look at that. You know what this is like? This is like the Scottish version of arancini. Mm. Like a little meat. We'll just make it into a ball. We'll bread it. We'll fry it. We'll just, you know, it's sustenance. So this is my deep fry Dutch oven. I keep this full of tallow all the time, and I probably clean the whole thing out like I did today so it would look nice for you. Maybe once every 3 or 4 months. I just reuse the tallow over and over and over again. So even after I fry the Scotch eggs in it today, I'll get done, let it cool down, put it back into the cold room, and then I'll just bring it out the next time I want to fry something. So this is going to last me for a very, very long time. Look at it, it's already melting. Heat it up to 375 degrees. Done? All right, your turn. Show me what you got.
Who do you think's more interesting, me or mommy? On camera.
I love that answer. I think he's way more interesting.
Wait,
he's way better to look at
camera.
Too.
Wait, filming?
No, like being the person being filmed. Who's more interesting?
Mom.
Yeah.
The more interesting person filming is if I'm talking behind the scenes.
Ah.
That's more important than anyway.
We each have our role to play.
All right, so is this gonna sustain you for a little while we work on the chicken house?
Yeah, I think so. Like you said, it's always hard to sink into a project and then have to figure out what to do for food and stuff. So the studio.
Chicken house?
Studio, the old chicken house becoming a studio space. Trying to get some work done on that, so. This will be good for a snack
yeah.
in between swinging a hammer.
Yeah. What's the next task in there? Now that the electrical's in and it's working, I guess we need to finish sheeting the walls so that they're ready for shiplap?
Yeah. So throwing up sheeting on the walls, and then we'll cover that with shiplap. Yeah. And kind of just the finish work sort of stuff.
That's the fun stuff.
Uh-huh.
I think I've settled on paint colors. We're going to get to reuse a bunch of old furniture that we already have. Make use of what we've got. Mm-hmm. It's a nice feeling.
Got to put flooring in. Yeah.
Yeah,
so,
cool.
But the big kind of clunky stuff, I guess, is out of the way.
Yeah, I'm excited to dive in. You got to come see this. Look at the gorgeous color of this tallow. Look at it. It's just golden nectar. Isn't that beautiful?
Mm-hmm.
So I guess technically this is kind of a shallow fry, mm-hmm. but that's going to be perfect. So at this point, you need to be careful. I've got about 1.5 inches of hot tallow in the bottom of my Dutch oven, and I'm going to use, this is called a spider I recently learned. I got it at a thrift store ages ago. I'm going to use this to gently lift the eggs into the oil. We'll have to work in batches to get all these done. I think it's actually really important to remember that when you're working out or when you're using your body, you need fat. You need calories. You need protein. I'm just, I guess what I'm trying to say is I'm really excited to eat these. Look at those. Aren't they gorgeous? Can you smell these?
Mm-hmm.
I wish you guys could smell these. I really am excited to eat one. Look how golden they got.
It's perfect.
And I know I already said this, but do not throw this tallow away. Reuse it, reuse it, reuse it. You'll know that it's time to change it when it's really, really dark. It'll just kind of stay this really super dark color and you might have some floaty bits in there. And then you know it's time to switch it out, but we actually fry foods a lot in our tallow and we don't change it too often. More often, I just add fresh tallow each time I use it. Look at that. It smells like heaven. All right, this is a bowl full of calories right here that I'm so excited to tear into. But because I'm a mom, I have to serve them with some green things. And because we're also trying to eat through our pantry of items, I think we're gonna serve them with some applesauce too, or some canned peaches. It's gonna be delicious all around.